Good morning, YouTube. I'm so excited to be checking in with you guys today. I know it has been a hot minute since I have really posted anything. I've been kind of MIA on social media, but I'll fill you in about what's been going on. I'm gonna head into my classroom now. My students are whiteboarding today, so I'm really excited. They'll also be doing a bell jar lab, which I'm pretty psyched about. We're doing gas laws in my CP chemistry class. And then for my AP class today, they're going to be making some presentations. So I'll tell you all about that. And of course, I'll tell you what's been going on with me, but I'll do that a little bit later. So I just finished with my CP chemistry classes for the morning. So I thought I'd sit down with you guys and just talk with you about what's been going on with me. I think we would all agree as teachers that this was by far the most difficult year we've all experienced. I've alluded to this before and I'll say it again. I was a brand new teacher all over again. I found myself every night creating new stuff so that it was more virtual friendly for my students. And then of course I was teaching AP, which was incredibly stressful. And I found myself every day faking it. And I know it sounds so bad, but I was faking it with my students that like, everything's great and I'm happy to see you and just be positive. And at the end of the day, when I would finish with my classes, I really had nothing left. Like I was spending all my time trying to be peppy and upbeat with my kids and pretend that everything's fine, when deep down I'm feeling completely depressed and upset about how the pandemic has just completely changed education. I did not have the relationships with my students that I wanted to. That was just disappointing in and of itself. And you know, when I had those struggling learners in my class, I was struggling to be able to reach them and talk with them, you know, send them a Google Meet invitation, students wouldn't respond. It just became incredibly difficult to balance everything. And at the end of the day, when I sat down and I was like, okay, I'm gonna record this video, I just had no energy left and I couldn't pop on here and add to that negativity, because there is so much negativity associated with the pandemic and teaching like this. And it was really hard for me to get out of that mindset. So I needed to take a step back and take care of my own mental health and, you know, just be there for my students and do the best job that I could for them. Of course, there was some guilt that came with it because I felt like I like left you guys. And I guess in some ways I know I did. But I really needed to do that because I was feeling so upset and so disappointed with the school year. And I just couldn't get on here and pretend like everything was fine. I just wasn't gonna do that because this year stunk. It did. But I learned a lot as a result. I learned a lot about me as a teacher. I learned a lot about me as a person. And I think that that overall has made me a better person, a better teacher, because of what I've gone through. And I think it also has made me better able to make connections with my kids, because connecting through a computer is so difficult. So I'm really glad that I feel like I'm kind of coming out of this and feeling much better, and that's why I'm here with you guys today. So I hope you understand. I hope you're not upset with me. Some of you were so sweet and you emailed me just to make sure that I was okay because you haven't seen anything from me. And I was like, wow, like that means so much to me that you look forward to my videos and you take some of the ideas and inspiration and use them in your classes. So thank you. I can't tell you how much that meant to me to receive those emails. Everything's fine. I just think we're all dealing with our own like mental health crisis at this point, but we're coming out of it. I'm excited to announce that we're definitely going to be back in person in September. At least that's what our governor in New Jersey says. So I'm really psyched for that. And I'm hoping that that will kind of help propel me into feeling much better about teaching and much better about what I'm doing in the classroom. So yeah, so I hope I'm not getting too like deep with you guys, but I just want you to know you were constantly on my mind. I thought about you guys a whole lot, but I just needed to kind of nurture myself and take care of my own mental health and be there for my students. My students are my priority, and so that's what I chose to do. I have to get ready for my AP class. I will check in with you guys a little bit later and tell you about the project that I did with my kids after the first administration of the exam. It's about 2:30. I just finished with my office hours for the day, so I thought I would pop on here and talk a little bit about what I've been doing with my AP chemistry students. So after the exam, we were, like I said, the first administration on May 7th. I gave them 2 weeks off. The intent was to give them time to study for their other AP chemistry exams, just give them some time to just decompress because we've been pushing all year long, especially in light of the pandemic, especially with the limited time. I was really pushing them hard. And so I gave them 2 weeks to chill, study, whatever they need to do, they got to do. We started back up and I gave them some time to start creating some I do, we do, you do notes. I do, we do, you do is a great strategy, especially if you're pressed for time. I loved it, and major shout out to the AP Chemistry Facebook group for the ideas and the inspiration. Emily Miller especially has graciously shared a lot of her resources. So they've been a complete asset to me and to my students, and I have no doubt that it really helped prepare them for the exam. So since the students were already comfortable with that format, I decided let's have them do some I do, we do, you do notes for topics that aren't covered by the exam. So I had my students, for example, one group was assigned phase diagrams, another set of students were assigned colligative properties. I also had some organic chemistry in there, and I had some nuclear chemistry. So there were a lot of different topics, and I assigned each group, it was a group of three, different roles within the group. So, for example, I had the scribe. The scribe was in charge of creating the notes for the group. I also had the assessor, which was in charge of creating the you do questions with like a typed answer key. And then I also had the student that would be the presenter, would be presenting it to the class. And that student was responsible for creating the we do, where they actually had to create their QR code and create a video and then obviously present it during class. I really liked that fact that like each kid had a job to do, so it didn't feel super overwhelming for the students. I thought it went really well in that regard. The kids that I've met with and talked with, they said that they liked it a lot, which I was like, great. I'm glad that they actually found the topics interesting and they found it kind of cool. So now I'm in the point where we are presenting and I'm seeing what the students did, and they're doing such a great job. Like, it makes me feel so good because they've been watching me all year with videos, and like some of it is like creeping into their own videos, like the way that they're teaching their peers. You know, the students start out with hi chemists, you know, it's just so cute. And it makes me feel so good. I just keep hoping that I'm going to see a Bitmoji because I'm a little crazy with my Bitmojis. I keep hoping in one of the videos or like one of the sets of notes I'm going to see a Bitmoji somewhere, but we'll see. Maybe not. I don't know. So it's been great. And so we'll be doing this for the rest of the week. Like I said, we only have a week of school left, and then I'll be grading them. There's also a peer assessment that we'll be doing. So the kids are going to assess each other on their level of engagement. They're also going to be looking at, did they complete the parts that they were supposed to, their attitude. So it really, I think doing it that way holds the students accountable. So I'm really psyched to see the rest of the presentations. I think it's going to be great. On that note, I think I'm going to get out of here because I'm like talking your ear off today. But I want you guys to know how much I value you, how much I've missed you, and I hope to do a lot more posting this summer. I will definitely be in school curriculum writing. Maybe I'll see some of you at the teacher prep room. I'll be talking this year about flipped learning and unit menus in my professional development courses. I'll put a link below if you're interested in learning about unit menus or the flipped classroom. And yeah, so I'm going to get out of here. I will check in with you guys soon, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your weekend.